Would you like to make great coffee at home for friends and family? We brought the automatic coffee maker into the lab to see what it takes to make great coffee with. Come join us as we take a closer look into drip coffee makers and find out what's in the cup. For these experiments, we used a coffee refractometer to measure the total dissolved solids in the brewed coffee. This showed how much coffee was taken out of the grounds by the hot water. We then compared the extraction efficiency of multiple brewing scenarios. From these results, we were able to break down proper brewing into five easy steps. As a bonus, we discovered a simple brewing hack that will elevate your coffee from good to great. So here are the five steps. Number one. Water accounts for nearly 99% of your coffee. It should be slightly hard with a neutral pH. Don't use overly softened or chlorinated water. The easiest way to ensure good quality water is to buy it bottled. We recommend using bottled spring water. Regular filtered or distilled water is too clean. Spring water will bring out your coffee's best flavor. Number two, start with fresh roasted whole bean coffee. If the coffee won't be used for a few weeks, it should be left sealed in a foil bag. After the coffee has been opened, try to use it up within 2 weeks. There's no need to store it in the fridge or freezer. It can be kept in the bag on the counter. Number three, a good grinder will make the biggest difference in the quality of your coffee. Oxygen is a silent killer. Grinding coffee increases the surface area and speeds up the process of staling. Look for either flat burr or conical burr grinders. Stay away from blade grinders. The coffee should be ground right before use with a size similar to refined white sugar. Remember, you're better off buying a cheap coffee maker and a quality burr grinder. Number four, the coffee to water ratio is where your own personal tastes come into play. A good place to start is a ratio of 1:17. If you have a small kitchen scale, weigh out your water, then divide by 17 for the weight of the coffee. If you don't have a scale, start with 2 tablespoons of ground coffee for every 6 ounces of water. Remember, when making coffee for a group, it's easier for guests to dilute strong coffee than make weak coffee stronger. Number five, my dad always says, you make your money in your details. Here's where your coffee will really start to shine. First, level your coffee maker. This reduces channeling and allows for even, thorough extraction. Second, only make 3/4 of a pot at a time. Most home coffee makers will have trouble when everything is maxed out. Lastly, keep your water in a container at room temperature. Cold water takes longer to heat up and can extend your brew cycle into over-extraction. Now for the bonus hack. While experimenting, we found the permanent mesh filter gave a silty finish with too heavy a body. The paper filter gave excellent clarity but would easily lose shape and stick to the side of the basket when wet. The paper flutes and basket ridges were unable to properly support the coffee bed. So here's a simple step to properly support the paper filter and allow for even extraction across the coffee bed. Simply place the paper filter inside the permanent filter. This gives both support and allows for extraction on all sides. For a little twist on this hack, if you want a little more body in your cup, place some coffee into the permanent filter, then insert the paper filter and add the rest of the coffee. There you have it. Now your home coffee maker can rival the hipster brew bar down the street. Remember, great coffee doesn't happen by accident. We hope you enjoyed this video because that's what's in the cup.